On this episode, we talk about being suited and booted. What does a real biker wear? What are the 1%er dress code protocols? There's a struggle between the old way and the new way, and we break it down on this episode of Demons Row TV. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby. Shout out to the ghosts and the ghost sets. Welcome to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture, where we cover everything motorcycle club involved. I'm Sos the Ghost. I'm your host for the evening, and I'm gonna put a little disclaimer out right now. These views are my views only, and what we're gonna talk about today is how 1%ers dress. Every club is different, depends on what coast you on. There's an old school and new school way of thinking, and they're starting to clash, so we're gonna break it down. But the first thing I want you to do, like we always do on this channel, is to hit me with that pound ghosting, and that lets me know you're alive and well, sitting on tools, doing what you do, or just part of the Demons Row community, one of my ghosts. Big shout to all my new subscribers. Welcome to the row. Make sure you hit that bell so you get the notification. Hit the like button. Shout to everybody getting the Demons Row bandanas. Get yours now. They're only 10 bucks on www.demonsrow.com. And let's break this down. What is the proper protocol for outlaw biker, for 1%er? What are their expectations? How are you supposed to dress when you're on your horse? Now, I'm gonna tell you right now, every club has different color setups and different ways they do things, but there's some things that go across the board. Being properly suited and booted, that's what we call it in the culture. You know, you can rock the Harley boots. You got the old school cats that rock the cowboy boots. I am from the East Coast, so the cowboy thing, not really my swag. I'm very different. I'm not into the Harley fashion. I wear ACGs. Those are basically Nike boots. That's like an East Coast thing. It's very popular on this side. If you're from the East, you know. Also, Tim boots. A lot of people on the East Coast wear the Tim boots, the old school constructs, or the all blacks. You can rock with those, you'll be good. Sneakers, they look down on heavy. I know some of the old school clubs allow them to wear Chucks, but a lot of clubs do not allow any use of sneakers when you're on that iron horse. Now jeans, they want you to have Levi's 501s. They want you to have, if your club allows, denim. Some clubs allow only all black. Some clubs only want you to wear black jeans, depending on your club's color setup. But one thing that is becoming a major problem is designer jeans. Designer jeans, a lot of us are growing up in this era now where there's a lot nicer jeans, distressed jeans. You know, skinny jeans is a 100% no-go. Like, no outlaw wants to see you wearing those skinny jeans. But distressed jeans, jeans that look nice, maybe have rips on them, there's a big power struggle between the old school and the new school. And there's one train of thought where it's like, you gotta stay that dirty biker that worked on your bike, and you know, you're wearing Levi's, American made stuff, and you're dirty, and you're not trying to be cool, or you're not trying to be clean. And then there's a new school that feels that, you know, you should be able to wear distressed jeans or nice looking jeans. What does that have to do with being a biker? Why do you have to wear the plainest jeans? I sit somewhere in the middle. I feel like as an outlaw, you really do what you please, but being in a club, you follow the club's protocols. So if your club is that way, you just gotta respect it. That's part of the game. But clubs that don't have in their bylaws that you have to wear a certain jean or can't have a pattern or whatever. It's a big power struggle. You have people taking in knives and cutting people's jeans, ripping them to shreds because they're wearing designer. It's a big struggle between the old way of thinking and the new way of thinking. When it comes to your cut, there's certain protocols with Outlaw Club cuts. You could wear the traditional outlaw style cut, or I like to call it the Undertaker, the long trench coat, badass, you know, blade looking. You know, a lot of 1%ers do wear those. Also, if you're in a club that does the denim, then you rock the blue denim depending on your club. A lot of clubs, you know, don't allow different colors. You can only wear the black. And then there's clubs that just wear the denim. It just really depends on your club. One thing that a lot of outlaws look down on is the vests that have like the three straps on the side that like Velcro. That's something that is more for a street bike look. And in certain clubs, they're not allowing you to wear that. Now, I'm not saying that there's no outlaw in the world that doesn't have that cut, but like standard, that's not one of the cuts that a lot of outlaws use. When it comes to the helmets, a lot of outlaws, a lot of 1%ers wear the German helmets. A lot of them don't like the full face. Me personally, I wear bandanas. I hardly ever wear a helmet. Shout to Mike Prolid, he sent me a dope helmet. Sometimes I wear it, but the majority of the time it's just bandana, shades, and you know the infamous Sostego skull mask, which I will be producing soon. But you got some outlaws that look down on other outlaws for wearing a full face. To me, you wear what you want. You know what I'm saying? A full face when it's freezing is convenient. You know what I mean? And when them rocks is hitting and everything, and if you get into a spill, you know, obviously with a full face mask, you're more protected. So let me know what you think in the comments. What's the medium? Where are you at? Are you with the old school? Like, it should be like our kids, grandkids should be dressing like the bikers did in the 60s, the 50s? Or should we, is it okay that we evolve? Like, what is cool to evolve with? Like, what is new trends that we could do that are in line and the old school will appreciate it? Or will the old school just always look down on the new school and that's just part of the way this goes? Let me know that in the comments. And shout to everybody that's been supporting the bandanas. We're also going to do a Demons Roll ride. And I've been saying on the lives, if you have footage and you're out at an event, or you have footage and you have something that you want to say to the community, send it to demonsrow@gmail.com and I will feature it. Either if it's a shorter clip, I'll put it live on church. If it's a longer clip and we could turn it into a video. But I had a goal to reach that 100K, and I said once I reach that 100K, I'm going to give back to the community and show them that Demons Row is the holy grail of MC culture, and it's not just the Sostego show. I have a channel for that. You can follow that channel, the Sostego channel. But what I wanna do is you send your videos to demonsrow@gmail.com and we start featuring your video, your point of view on this channel, and truly show that it's all about community. Thank you for tuning in to Demons Row TV, the holy grail of MC culture. Like, subscribe, and comment. And oh yeah, we ghosting, baby.